Yeah, it was great. Alright, we're not praying the transcend prayer, is what I'm saying.
Good morning, everyone. How's it going? My name is Will Hickel. I'm a parishioner here. A few announcements. We have a new carnival website. Please go to saintanneparish.org/carnival. You can plan your time and find all the info you need if you'd like to volunteer, sponsor, or donate an item for the silent auction. Again, that's saintanneparish.org/carnival. Our Bible studies are open, but registrations are closing soon. We have 5 Bible studies open that cover the New Testament, community, and much more. To learn more, you can go to the link found in your song sheet or in the bulletin. We want to hear from each and every one of you about our Transcend campaign, and we've made it easier than ever to participate for those who haven't completed the survey online. We have an in-pew option this time. I'm sure you guys have seen them on the ends of your pews. So please take one per family and pass them down. You can fill out your survey and place it in the collection basket. There's a designated box at the Welcome Center or gray baskets at the exits. If you need more time, drop it off at the parish office, or there's a QR code and you can fill it out online. Thank you for your valuable feedback. Lastly, the Knights of Columbus have their pancake breakfast this morning, so please visit them in the Assisi Hall that way after Mass. Thanks for your attention. Now, please stand up and introduce yourself to your neighbors.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters of St. Anne's, I have missed you. I don't know if you've noticed, I've been gone for the past 10 days. Last weekend, I was able to be the team priest for a Franciscan University of Steubenville conference up in the Boston area. And then I did a 6-day silent retreat where I didn't talk. There were no emails, no phone calls, no text messages. It was beautiful, just a time of prayer with the Lord. And so I've saved up all of my words for this mass. But it was really a great time, and I prayed for all of you over this time, but I am happy to be back and to be able to celebrate this Mass with you today. In our gospel, we will hear about the treasure that is beyond price, that when it is found, we give all that we own so that we may acquire it. The Lord has given us the kingdom. He has given us an invitation to live with Him. For those moments in our lives where we have held back, where we haven't given our all to the beauty of this gift. Let us begin this Mass by acknowledging our sins and our selfishness so that we may be prepared to celebrate the sacred mysteries.
You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory, Lord God, heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ.
Let us pray. O God, protector of those who hope in you, without whom nothing has firm foundation, without whom nothing is holy, bestow in abundance your mercy upon us, and grant that with you as our ruler and guide, we may use the good things that pass in such a way as to hold fast even now to those that ever endure. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
A reading from the book of Kings. The Lord appeared to Solomon in a dream at night. God said, "Ask something of me, and I will give it to you." Solomon answered, "O Lord, my God, you have made me, your servant, king to succeed my father David. But I am a mere youth, not knowing at all how to act. I serve you in the midst of the people whom you have chosen, a people so vast that it cannot be numbered or counted. Give your servant, therefore, an understanding heart to judge your people and to distinguish right from wrong. For who is able to govern this vast people of yours?" The Lord was pleased that Solomon made this request. So God said to him, "Because you have asked for this, not for a long life for yourself, nor for riches, nor for the life of your enemies, but for understanding, so that you may know what is right, I do as you requested. I give you a heart so wise and understanding that there has never been anyone like you up to now, and after you, there will come no one to equal you." The word of the Lord.
To me. A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, we know that all things work for good for those who love God, who are called according to his purpose. For those he foreknew, he also predestined to be conformed to the image of his Son, so that he might be the firstborn among many brothers and sisters. And those he predestined, he also called. And those he called, he also justified. And those he justified, he also glorified. The word of the Lord.
Be with you
and with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "The kingdom of heaven is like a treasure buried in a field, which a person finds and hides again, and out of joy goes and sells all that he has and buys that field. Again, the kingdom of heaven is like a merchant searching for fine pearls. When he finds a pearl of great price, he goes and sells all that he has and buys it. Again, the kingdom of heaven is like a net thrown into the sea, which collects fish of every kind. When it is full, they haul it ashore and sit down to put what is good into buckets, and what is bad, they throw away. Thus it will be at the end of the age. The angels will go out and separate the wicked from the righteous and throw them into the fiery furnace. There will be wailing and grinding of teeth." "Do you understand all these things?" They answered, "Yes." And he replied, "Then every scribe who has been instructed in the kingdom of heaven is like the head of a household who brings from his storeroom both the new and the old." The Gospel of the Lord.
Have you seen this new Mission Impossible movie? It is insane. It is like a roller coaster of adrenaline all the way through, start to finish. Like, it just starts, you're like, let's go, right? And Tom Cruise, if you've ever seen one of these movies, does all of his own stunts. And like hanging onto the side of a plane. And in this one, he did one of the most dangerous stunts that they have ever recorded in a movie. Ever. It's like a 100-yard-long ramp up this hill, off of this cliff, holding onto a motorcycle, just off into the oblivion. and he falls for like 10 seconds and then like has a base jumping parachute. And so I watched an interview of his crew that watched him do this. He did it six times, not once, six times. He like ramped up and went off of this into the oblivion, off of this cliff, and they were just all terrified because he's the star of the show. Right? And so they are watching him just fall into the oblivion, counting one, two, three, four. 10 seconds they wait. And they're like, good canopy, meaning the parachute opened and the star did not die. And so as he's going through this, pumping up his crew, Tom Cruise looks at everybody that is obviously nervous and he says to them, let's not be careful, let's be confident. And although Tom Cruise is not a believer, I love that line. Let us not be careful, let us be confident. There's far too often, I think, in our life, and especially in our spiritual life, where we are careful with the Lord and with the invitation towards the kingdom. In the gospel today, it is clear that there is a treasure beyond price that each of us has been offered, given, invited to be part of. We have found it. And the call is to sell all we own to be able to receive this beautiful gift. The man went away and sold all that he had so that he could procure the field where the treasure was buried. Oftentimes, we're too careful. We don't commit everything to the Lord. We're like, here's 80%, but I'm gonna keep 20% in reserve just in case there's a bad day, just in case you, the Lord, does not take care of me. Let us not be careful. Let us be confident. Because if we hold back, we're going to find that we do not have enough to receive what the Lord has for us in the pearl of great price. Our second reading from Romans chapter 8 is one of my favorites. It's one that I hold very close to my heart. I've memorized it, and it comes up often. It says, for those of us who love God, all things work for the good, for he has predestined us to be like his son. The scripture verse does not say that everything in our life is going to be good and easy. What it does say, though, is that God's goodness and his love and his invitation and the kingdom that he gives us is so good that even the bad within our lives pales in comparison to the beauty and love that he offers us. That his goodness is so good that even when it encounters the bad, that in the end, it will overwhelm it to goodness. Do we believe this enough to entrust everything to him? St. Augustine used to say, give me holiness, but not yet. And I think that that's sometimes our spirit, that we hold back everything. But the Lord is worthy of our confidence. How do I know this? I would like us to change our perspective of the gospel. I'd like to flip our gospel on its side to just get a little bit more truth out of it. Obviously, the person who's meant to sell everything is us for the treasure that is buried. But I want us to look at it slightly differently. And when I looked at it this way, it kind of blew my mind. Look at it this way. That the pearl of great price, or the treasure beyond worth, is you. That for Jesus Christ, you are a treasure beyond price. a pearl that is worth more than you could ever possibly imagine. And he gave everything for you. He kept nothing back, dying on the cross, purchasing you and ransoming you from slavery to sin and death. And even when we were covered with sin, and even when all that is seen in the world is dirt, he uncovered our dignity and our beauty, restored us, and gave everything for you, whom he loved, his treasure beyond worth. And so, in confidence, we can go to him and we can give all that we have because he first gave everything for you. Let us not be careful. Let us be confident. If there is a part of your life of sin, if there is a part of your life that you are holding back, let that love of the Lord given and poured into our heart by the Spirit pervade us, so that we can confidently run to him, so that we may not be found wanting, but receive, because the Lord has destined us, predestined us for eternity and joy and happiness with him. It is not we who first loved him, it is him who first loved us. And he has given everything for his pearl of great price. Let us respond with confidence and give everything for him. Please remain seated. We are well trained, everybody. As many of you know, this past July 26th was the feast day of St. Anne and St. Joachim, the feast day of our patroness, St. Anne. And St. Anne and St. Joachim were the parents of our Blessed Virgin Mary, meaning that they were the grandparents of Jesus. And I love to ponder and to think about our Lord and Savior in the arms of St. Anne, his grandmother. And scripture does not record what like her grandma title was. Was it mama? Was it granny? Who knows, right? But I like to imagine that love and that tenderness that our Lord had for St. Anne. And so today on her feast day, as is our tradition here, we like to bless all of the grandparents in our community. And so if you are a grandparent, would you please stand? Thank you so much for the gift that you are to your families and to our community. Please bow your head for God's blessing. Lord Jesus, you were born of the Virgin Mary, the daughter of St. Joachim and St. Anne. Look with love on these grandparents. Protect them. They are the source of enrichment for families, for the church, and for all society. Support them. As they grow older, may they continue to be for their families strong pillars of gospel faith, guardians of noble domestic ideals, living treasures of sound religious traditions. Make them teachers of wisdom and courage, that they may pass on to future generations the fruits of their mature human and spiritual experience. Mary, Mother of all the living, keep grandparents constantly in your care. Accompany them on their earthly pilgrimage, and by your prayer, grant that all families may one day be reunited in our heavenly homeland, where you await all humanity for the great embrace of life without end. Amen. And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down upon you and remain with you forever. Amen. May we all please stand. Let us join together in professing our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. For the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and life of the world.
Amen.
God our Father, filled with great confidence in your love for us through Christ Jesus, we give all that we have as we turn to you with our prayers.
That the Lord may give wise and understanding hearts to those entrusted with leading the church, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For peace in our streets, among our nations, and peace in our hearts, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For awareness of the preciousness of life from conception to natural death, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For a greater awareness of the riches of every vocation to love Christ, and that more men and women will respond to his invitation to follow him as priests, deacons, and in the consecrated life, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all of us here may be strengthened in love through participation in the word and sacraments, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick and all those who care for them, may God's grace bring them healing and strength, especially those whose names are on the prayer chain. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those called from this life may be justified and glorified by God. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. I'd like to also pray, just in response to the gospel, if there's any part of our life in the Lord that we are holding back from him, any area that he wants, perhaps sinfulness, perhaps a sphere of influence that we have in the world, may we in confidence give it to him fully, allowing his love and his invitation to bear much fruit. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear.
God, our Father, in complete trust of your divine plan, the predestination that you have for us in your Son and in our eternal homeland, we offer you these prayers that you may hear and answer them according to your will through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated. Brothers and sisters, before we prepare our altar, I would like to draw your attention to a survey that is in our pews. Do we have any Aggies in the church today? Yesterday, I was able to go to the dedication of St. Mary's in College Station, and it was a beautiful church, and it had a tabernacle in the center. It was much the same shape as ours, and I can't help but just know that the Holy Spirit is calling our community to bring a tabernacle and more beauty into our church and our sanctuary space. And so we have been praying about this in this Transcend campaign, and that we're ending during the portion of our feedback time, but we want to make sure that everyone had an opportunity to fill out our survey. And so if each family would see the survey at the end of the pew, we're going to take a couple minutes right now and give you an opportunity, if you have not yet, to, if you have filled out our survey, just to pray for this future endeavor. If you have not, to fill out this survey about what do you think about bringing a tabernacle into the main church. We have some bishop has invited us to consider what would it look like if we painted some of the walls and added some sacred art or some more statues for some saint intercessions, maybe even repainting our Transfiguration mural in the back. And so we really want to pray and to hear your words from that. So if we could fill those out, I'd appreciate it. You can put them in the collection basket as it is passed around, or if you need a little bit more time, you can drop it in the baskets as you leave church today, or go online and find more information about this campaign. Thank you.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Accept, O Lord, we pray, the offerings which we bring from the abundance of your gifts, that through the powerful working of your grace, these most sacred mysteries may sanctify our present way of life and lead us to eternal gladness through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For by his birth, he brought renewal to humanity's fallen state, and by his suffering, canceled out our sins. By his rising from the dead, he has opened the way to eternal life, and by ascending to you, O Father, he has unlocked the gates of heaven. And so, with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. And giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread, we proclaim your death, O Lord.
Therefore, Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray upon the oblation of your church, in recognizing the sacrificial victim, by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint Anne and with Saint Joachim, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May the sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis our Pope and Edward our bishops, Gregory his assisting bishop, the order bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world, to our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life. Give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of Christ's peace.
Have mercy on us.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter into my room, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Body of Christ, keep me safe.
Brothers and sisters, it is important for us to remember that we as Catholics believe something truly unique about the Eucharist, that it is the very real presence of Jesus Christ. Therefore, only Catholics are able to receive the Eucharist during this time of Holy Communion. If you are visiting with us from a different Protestant denomination, or you are just beginning your walk with Jesus, or perhaps you are a Catholic that does not regularly practice their faith or is not prepared to receive Communion this weekend, we invite you to come forward for a blessing if you wish. You can indicate that you would like a blessing by placing your hands over your heart as a sign of prayer, bowing, and pausing for a moment as you reach the front of our ordinary communion line. Thank you.
song we could ever sing. Worthy of all the praise we could ever bring. Worthy of every breath we could ever breathe. We live for you. We live for you. Jesus, the name above every other name. Jesus, the only one who could ever say, worthy of every breath we could ever breathe. We live for you. We live for you, Lord. For you are holy. There is no one like you. There is none beside.
In you alone. are holy. There is none like you. There is none beside you. Open up my eyes in wonder. Show me who you are and fill me with your heart and lead me in your love to those around me.
Thank you.
I would just invite us as we have received our Lord in the sacrament. The Lord Jesus, who gave everything for us, that we have been purchased at a price, that we may receive that great love, and that may fill us with confidence to give all we have for Him who first loved us. Amen. Let us pray. We have consumed, O Lord, this divine sacrament, the perpetual memorial of the passion of your Son. Grant, we pray, that this gift, which he himself gave us with love beyond all telling, may profit us for salvation through Christ our Lord. Amen. Brothers and sisters, we have a pancake breakfast over in our Assisi Hall over there. It is a great opportunity not to just have some pancakes and some eggs and some great food, but to gather together in fellowship. So you can head on over there. Also, if it has been your birthday, your anniversary, if it's just been a rough week, Deacon and I would love to give you a blessing or to pray with you after Mass. Or if you're new or visiting, we would love to meet you as well. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
Shelter from the stormy blast.